I'm right. Let me see if I can get my finger right there. VendorsUnited.com is where all the best vendors in the world have a little private mastermind group. And you can get all kinds of help if you're just starting out or you've been in business 10 years and you want to make more money with less time. That's where you go. Or you want some new tips and tricks and that kind of stuff. We even have a 5-day free pass there and you get full access. So you can try that out, VendorsUnited.com. Now over here, and I have a subject tonight, and this will be important to a lot of people, but LearnHotDogs.com is where you can find the answers to a lot of questions that get asked. I get asked daily. I get lots of emails with questions about business, whether it's kettle corn to lemonade to hot dogs to just normal street food, street corn, walking tacos, taco trucks, you name it. So you can find answers there, and lots of them. There's years and years of stuff there. One of the things, though, that has that I love to talk about is pre-seasoning your water. So when you pre-season your water, and I'm talking about boiling dogs or dirty water dogs, it's where you take water, put it in your steam pan, or your, we call them steam pans, but you put it in your pan, and it's direct heat, so there's fire right underneath it, and you can boil that water up, but you can throw in a garlic clove, you can throw in a beer, you can throw in a, I like using the beef bouillon or the chicken bouillon, and now they've got the bouillons in paste form, so you can get the right amount of flavoring and stuff. I do have a buddy, and I have to tell you this, good friend of mine, he's been on here a lot of times with me, Jason Brown, has had a enormously successful business in a small town of 9,000 people, and he knows his stuff. I mean, he served Beyonce and Jay-Z at the concerts in Philadelphia. He's done it all. And he disagrees with me on this, but we'll just agree to disagree because this works, and try it at home if you want. Test my advice out. So take a beef bouillon cube or some beef paste or the vegetable paste or the chicken paste, whatever you want, garlic. Now they have it in garlic. And put it in water. Throw your beer in there or garlic clove. And then add your hot dogs. And when it's boiling, add your hot dogs, boil your dogs up from frozen or from thawed out. About 7.5 minutes on frozen dogs. And depending on the ambient temperatures and size of your pan and all that mess. But bottom line is, about 7 minutes. So you get that going and then you turn it off before they start splitting open, right? Then you go, man, I've got to sit these dogs here in the hot water as I serve them until they get ordered. Well, the nice part is when you put hot dogs or sausages in boiling water, typically saps out the flavor. The water being clean sucks all the flavor out of the meat. So a lot of vendors add and pre-season the water. And I call it pre-saturating the water. So I basically fill the water with seasoning so that it doesn't sap out the dog's flavors, and it adds a little extra touch to the dogs. Now, Jason Brown, my buddy, he will tell you that that doesn't work, that it just doesn't work. Well, I caught him in a little triangle. I said, listen here, buddy. I said, how about this? We'll bet $100 on it, and I get to pre-season the water, and you eat it. And he goes, what's pre-season? I said, I'm going to put every hot pepper known to man, ghost peppers, Carolina Reapers, I'm putting it all in there. And he goes, I ain't eating a hot dog out of that. And I said, why not? If the hot dog doesn't absorb it, why do you care? And so he never agreed with me on it. But the point is, it works. So put the seasonings in the water, and you will come out with a better dog. Okay, you can take a bland hot dog, a basic hot dog, and make it better by doing that. And I know some of you may go, well, I agree with Jason. Well, try it at home, test it out and see. Now, I like to leave that in the pan. Now, I will tell you this: a lot of people go, I don't want my dog splitting, and I agree. Okay, but we have some vendors in VU that literally intentionally overboil their dogs till they split, and they serve them that way, because then the condiments go down into the meat because they're all split up and cracked, and they may not look as appealing, but they taste delicious. And then I got to looking, and I did a video on this. I ordered some hot dogs from, I think it was called New York Deli, and I don't remember the name of the hot dog, but they are pop opens, and so they're called pop open dogs. They intentionally pop open. They are phenomenal. Probably the favorite, if not next to, head and head, neck and neck with one of my favorites. So it is a phenomenal dog. They make them in red and white dogs. They are delicious hot dogs, and they have a unique ability. Whether they're boiled, grilled, steamed, they pop open. And then all the flavor juices get up in there, and it's perfect, okay? Now, you may be going, Ben, I ain't gonna be boiling dogs. Well, this doesn't apply to you then, okay? But guess what? You can pre-season steam water. So even if you're steaming, like rapid steaming that I teach, which happens quick with the hot dogs, you know, put two in, take two out, put two in, take two out, and you just do that over and over, that works even with seasoned water. So you get this flavor that gets on the hot dog or the sausage, and people like it. It makes your business more unique with a very easy step. Now, I've got vendors that pre-season their water with all kinds of stuff. My tried and true, can of beer, because you don't do this every time you add hot dogs because the water stays in there, right? Every now and then you have to add a little water, but by then you've got seasonings from the hot dogs that is added to it and the grease from the hot dogs, so it's made it even better. So you rarely have to add anything. A beer, and I'm talking like a half size pan or a third size pan, I'll use a beer, a whole beer, and then I'll put a garlic clove, and then I'll put either a beef bouillon or a chicken bouillon cube and let it roll. Some vendors do add all kinds of other seasonings, from cumin to paprika, all kinds of stuff. And it smells good. It smells up the air. It's kind of like when you go to the state fair and they're grilling Italian sausages and they got peppers and onions going. Well, that smell, everybody knows what it is. And so you're creating a little niche in your own market by doing that. And I guess that's it. Very simple subject, but easy to try at home, easy to test out. And you'll even smell it while it's doing it on your home stove and you'll go, man, I like that. That'd bring in more people probably, and it probably will. So try it out, test it at home, and then test it on your cart, and it will help your hot dogs work out better, and especially if you're buying a less flavorful dog, let's say. I hate to say cheaper, but you're buying a less flavorful dog that doesn't have a lot of seasoning in it because they scrimped on that, you can jack it up a notch with your own. And so it makes it real easy. I love you, and I will see you tomorrow.